You've been racing for 23 hours. There's one clue left to the finish. The purple team is right behind you. Expect pain. Because if you don't, you will hope to die. And now, live from the Market Theater in downtown Seattle, it's time for America's most dangerous high-stakes game show, where highly trained teams race against danger for a shot at immortality. It's time to expect pain, so let's give it up for your Hope to Die host and MC, Chet Ruffle!
But how about 2 more minutes and then what is it?
It's weird.
Whoa!
The tree turned out to be the weak point. I thought it was gonna be the jack before this.
Well done. Now, find the iron horse at exit 54.
We're heading further east.
These things worked like a charm in the tunnel.
I
say that again for the camera, Joe?
And there was a point there where I was pretty sure the rest of the team bomb was going to be fishing me out of the water. anyway.
Be careful, there's a guy there called the Flaming Geezer.
Yeah, come here.
Don't pay any attention to him. Flaming Geyser you want.
You gotta keep them separated.
We had left the lights on in the car to help us see what we were doing, and I guess this thing has got the monster battery juice requirements, and we just couldn't start the RV, so we had to call a tow truck.
Ah!
Grabbing a little shut-eye there. Yeah, it's kind of nice to take a nap when you're dead beat tired. Uh-huh. Well, listen, you're doing awfully well. Now, here's where you want to go next.
Excuse me. Have you heard of Harper's Fishing Dock?
Why, sure I have. There's good fishing there.
Hey! Man, you're disrespecting me. Take them out. Gotta keep them separated.
H2D.
I'm Bruce. I'm your host today. I used to be a floor manager. Now I'm a DJ. Hey, we're taking your request at a request line.
Hey, H2D.
What would you like to hear?
You know what? Keep on listening and I'll see what I can do, all right?
I've had my share of sand kicked in my face.
We're at the Coldwell Banker in Port Orchard trying to find information about the Cedar Heights Naval Air Station. The air station's so secret, even the Navy's never heard of it.
We must have spent an hour, hour and a half deciphering these numbers. And when we finally got it, it was like beating us over the head. It was like so obvious what it was that we all feel kind of, well, we should have seen it earlier.
During the show, when you were back behind
there,
you looked like hell.
We just passed Team Green, by the way.
Woohoo!
Yeah!
Let's hear it for not being last!
You!
That's us!
Are we having a good time, pirates?
You sound pathetic.
You know, speaking of coffee, Larsy, we spilled a little. I'm Lars, goddammit.
See, it's really
We would be able to solve this if we went to sleep.
So we got pulled over for speeding. Scoot was driving, we were doing cops at 72.
I slept 2.5 hours in class since Thursday.
Is I'm a man who's not afraid to take chances. You all know that about me. And quite frankly, there was a disagreement yesterday when purchasing food with Christina. She said I'd gone a little overboard. I sincerely believe she was wrong, so I said, let's put a challenge. Loser, she says, there's going to be food left over. I say, nay. And loser has to be the barnyard animal of the winner's choice. Well, there's mainly a conspiracy against me. And to humiliate me, my friend saw to it that I would lose this bet. So I am losing, but as a gentleman, I will see to my portion. So I now need to perform. I've been told that I'm a donkey with rabies, a very common yet frightening barnyard animal.
Make it good.
Okay. First of all, I notice you're all backing away from me.
We're afraid you're going to start kicking dirt around.
It starts off a little slow. And then the virus actually spreads cerebriform and occupies neural cells. That's more or less what it looks like.
That was awesome!
Have a donkey.
Bravo!